Hello, thank you for joining me once again on OBESIP Universal Statisticals. On today's video tutorial, we shall be carrying out the estimation procedure for univariate volatility modeling. And this is a part one of this video. Okay. Now, recent developments in financial econometrics have led to the use of models and techniques that can model the attitude of investors not only towards expected returns, but also towards risk or uncertainty, all right, which now makes the volatility modeling imperative. Now, for you to carry out volatility modeling, the first thing you need to do is to ensure that your data are high-frequency data. And these high-frequency data include daily, monthly, quarterly, etc. This study will rely on monthly data for the analysis, okay? Now, the next thing there is to compute return of series, because investors are actually interested in returns of their investment. Okay, after computing the return of series, you need to graph this return of series at both level and returns. Okay, you need to graph your data at both levels and the return series. And the essence of doing that, okay, is to find out if there is evidence of volatility clustering. That is, periods of high volatility, whether they are followed by periods of tranquility, all right? And second is to know whether there is evidence of structural breaks in the series. Now, there are two tests you need to conduct before carrying out your volatility modeling. And the first test there is the serial correlation test, okay, and the heteroscedasticity test. These two tests are usually called pretest, okay, formal pretest. You need to also know that the univariate volatility model is only valid if there is presence of serial correlation and arch effects. In other words, you are expected to reject the null hypothesis of no serial correlation and no heteroscedasticity for the univariate volatility framework to be valid for analysis under pre-estimation test. Okay. Now, the next step up there is the model proper. There are about four models you need to run, each of them, for you to know the final one to select from. Okay, and this model include ARCH, GAC, EGAC, and GJR GAC models. The usual concern when dealing with ARCH type model is how to determine the appropriate lag length for the model. We shall assume to have five competing ARCH type models, namely ARCH 1 to ARCH 5 models. Next up is to determine the appropriate model using relevant selection criteria such as SIC, which is Swatch Information Criterion, and AIC, which is Archaic Information Criterion. This study will, however, rely on SIC. The model with the least SIC value is the best model, and the corresponding lag length is the optimal lag length for the series. Okay. Now, you also need to evaluate the behavior of shocks to the returns series. Are the effects of these shocks permanent or temporary? If they are temporary, how long does it take for the initial impact of shocks to be halved? If the asymmetric GAC model is the preferred model, that is out of the five model out of the four model you've estimated, then the interpretation should be extended to include asymmetric effects of shocks. And finally, you need to conduct what we call post-estimation test. Okay, now the post-estimation test involves serial correlation test and heteroscedasticity test. Under serial correlation test, you are not expected to reject the null hypothesis of no serial correlation at this stage. Okay, under heteroscedasticity test, you are not expected to reject the null hypothesis of no ACT effect at this stage. Okay, note also that the post-estimation tests are conducted on the best model you are to select from. For the analysis to be considered meaningful, you are not expected to reject the null hypothesis of these two tests, okay? You must have estimated the best model before conducting the post-estimation test. All right, so basically these are the procedures you need to employ when conducting volatility modeling or univariate series. Okay, kindly watch our next video for the hands-on proper using eViews, okay? Kindly watch the next video or the part two of this video for the hands-on proper using eViews. Please, if this is your first time of watching this video, kindly hit the subscribe button to receive updates on videos of analysis. Thank you very much for listening.